Hello and welcome back to Ivy Lilia. If you're new, make sure to subscribe. Today we're talking about advice for new IB students. IB can seem really overwhelming from the outside, and I think part of that is because there's a lot of like IB horror stories from past IB kids or kids that are in the IB program now. Don't believe everything you hear. I think people really like to complain about how hard they're working or how much they study when it's really not accurate. The IB is not as overwhelming or difficult as it seems from the outside, but don't let that be an excuse to not give it your all, because it is a pretty demanding program overall. So here's some tips to get ready for your first year in IB. Number one. Take time to learn how to learn. IB is pretty demanding because you have to juggle all the classes at once. So it's really important to focus your energy on ensuring that you're learning how to best learn the material. Focus on learning what type of note-taking helps you internalize the information or pay attention during class. What style of organization helps you feel motivated to study? Don't use rote memorization as a cop-out. Learn what strategies work best for you to internalize information long-term. I think that the IB really forces you to become a learner, and if you consciously know that you need to develop these skills to learn, it'll give you a leg up above any other high schooler because other high school curriculums don't ask you to be a lifelong learner in the same way that IB does. Remember, study smarter and not harder. And part of that is learning what works best for you. Number two, study to understand, not just to cram. If you're cramming for every single assignment and test, you're not taking in the information and you are going to have such an awful IB exam experience. Because when it comes to 2 years of curriculum, you need to have a lot of it internalized so you don't have to go back and cram everything. I know I crammed before pretty much every math test, and I really struggled with remembering how to do certain concepts or what certain rules were for certain concepts because I didn't take the time to really learn it. I just crammed. But compare that to history, where I really took the time to analyze and understand and make connections between the content. Then I didn't have to study as hard before the exam because I had studied throughout the entire course. So make sure you're keeping exams in mind. Don't take shortcuts on learning concepts or studying when you could work a little bit harder and save yourself the time and energy during exams. Tip number three. Know that your second year of IB is much more demanding than your first year. Part of this is because the IB curriculum mandates that certain assessments happen specifically during your second year. So your first year is a lot about building skills and understanding how things work in IB and knowing the correct terminology and skills that you'll need to build on in your second year. Second year is where it all goes ham. You need to be so prepared to devote a lot more time to your IB studies and academics in your second year than you did your first year. During your first year, ensure that you have a lot of time management skills. Understand how things work for you and know how much time you need in order to be successful. One more thing, ensure that you can get as many IB requirements out of the way during your first year and leave as much free time as possible during your second. Whether that's working on your extended essay or completing CAS requirements, just keep in mind that you should do as much as possible in your first year. Number four, know what is expected of you. A lot of people didn't know what was on paper one or paper two or paper three for a certain subject right up before, like a week before our exams, which is absurd. Okay, granted, you don't need to know what's on the exams going straight into your first year of IB. Knowing what to study for will help you because ultimately you've internalized the right content. It doesn't help you to memorize a bunch of really weird out there facts if you're never going to need it. So keep in mind what the end goal is for IB, and that's what content you'll be tested over. Number five, keep something in mind that motivates you beyond IB scores. It can get really draining really quickly to just think, I want a 7 in this class. Don't focus on the score, don't focus on the points. think about how much you're growing as a student. I've said this once, I'll say it a million times. If you focus just on the points, you're not going to be happy with yourself at the end of your IB experience. If you focus on how much better you are at studying or thinking about abstract concepts, then you'll get a lot more out of your IB experience and you won't feel frustrated. Number six, practice writing really, really fast. Learning how to write really quickly is half about developing the muscles and half about developing the skills and strategies you need to think that quickly on the fly and write a really outstanding essay fast. It is so important to practice writing essays under time constraints, not only so you understand how quickly you have to write, but also so you understand how to organize and clearly and effectively write the essay, because it's not enough just to get the words on the page. It has to make sense and it has to be in a coherent, organized way. Number seven, don't be overwhelmed. Yes, the IB curriculum can seem really hard. If I had looked at what I was going to be doing at the end of my second year as a first year, I would be stressed beyond belief because it's a really high level of academics and analysis and critical thought. But the good news is the IB curriculum is structured so well. Your first year doesn't just start at that difficulty. The curriculum is designed to prepare you. So every step of the way, as it gets harder, you don't really feel that you're being challenged even more. It's the same level, but you're growing exponentially as a student. The worst thing you can do going into the IB program is be stressed and overwhelmed and all over the place, because that's not going to help you. If you're cool, calm, and know that ultimately the IB does want to help you as a student, like, yes, weird thought, but they do want you to be a good student and they're trying their best to make you a really exemplary student. So stay organized, stay calm, and you will excel in IB. If you need any other advice or need someone to calm your nerves, make sure to comment or DM me on Instagram. I would be more than happy to help. If you liked this video, then you'll probably like some of my other ones. So make sure to check them out. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you later.